Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel, and today I'm going to help you set up StreamElements ground control. So what can you do with this? One of the things you can do is watch your feed, so see if you got some bits, if you got some subs, follows, and also get a custom name for your StreamElements bot, which is a very important one, I think. So this is how it looks like. This little box here. You'll see bits, follows, hosts, subs in here, the activities. And you will have pending approval here if you have mod tools on for those activities. You can obviously make this way bigger if you want. I just don't like it to fill the whole screen because you can't read the chat and stuff like that now. You can also repeat things in here by clicking on the repeat sign. Which is very handy if you've missed something or there was a sub and you went to the bathroom. So how do we get this box, right? You go to streamelements.com/groundcontrol. It will look like this. So just click on this and you can install it there and it will be installed. So you can just search it into your Windows and it will be opening like this. The thing is though, it will not display your activities yet. How do we get that? You click on this cogwheel here. What you see now is all my settings. First thing you want to do is get your token here. How do we find the token? You go to streamelements.com and click on my dashboard or login if you didn't do that with Twitch. Then you click at your channel on this little arrow and then settings. Okay, so this is all information about your account. To actually see that token, click on Show Secrets, and you will see it underneath here. I can't do that because you guys can't see it, you know? You copy that whole code, go back to your settings, and paste it in here. You can also set a key binding for skipping alerts here. You can also have a custom bot name, but this might not be visible for you yet. There are a few things you need to do to make that actually visible. Which are, one of them is a StreamElements is made a mod and is in your chat. So how do we do this? We go to our dashboard and you just set this up basically. Just log in here. And you can have it go into the chat here, I believe. You can also go away. Then you go to Twitch. Go to your own channel and type /mod and StreamElements. If you do this, it says that it's already a moderator at my place, but it will be adding StreamElements as a moderator on your channel. This is necessary because otherwise it can't do anything. Second step you need to do is activate one of these overlays. If you want to know how you can make overlays and how you can actually set them in your OBS so they work, I will refer to my other video where I explain how to set up StreamElements. The third thing you need to do is have a tipping link working. So you go to tipping settings here and then again to tipping settings and you connect your PayPal right here. You can also set up the rest of the tipping settings. I explained that in the other video, StreamElements tutorial. And then what you need to do after is click on Tip Panel Setup and copy this link. Just clicking on it will copy it. Okay? You go back to your own channel, go to Panels, click on Edit Panels, and you can add a panel here. I have a lot already. Text or image panel, and you enter the link in here. Add an image with it, I don't know, a donation image, maybe the word donation, I don't know, so that you get a button that looks like this. You click on it, you will actually go to the tipping page of my stream. The fourth thing you want to do is make a new account for your Twitch bot on Twitch. So you just log out on your Twitch and click on sign up. Enter your name, which I recommend just using your name with the word bot after it, or well, maybe a player in your name with the word bot in it, and then you're set. And then make sure that you're still logged in the bot account. You go back to the ground control, You go here and click on generate token. You can generate a token there, copy it and paste it in this thing here. And if everything is alright, you can click on test bot and you will see that it says something. That's basically how we get the custom bot name in StreamElements. One tip though, keep this thing running. If you quit this ground control, the bot will not have your custom name, but it will still have the StreamElements name. So that was it for this video. Thank you for watching. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. And also, subscribe to my YouTube channel for more tutorial videos about everything containing streaming. And check out my socials in the description. Guys, thanks for watching. Bye!